All right, so I was cleaning out the garage, getting rid of some old parts from these builds of these first gens that I've done, and I came across these mixture control valves here up in the attic I was going to throw away. And so I figured I'd take them apart and just kind of see what's inside, because there's some theories about what it does, and I always take them off the bike because I think they do more harm than good when they go bad. We'll look at what makes them go bad, and then also kind of what they do, and see what's going on, because I have one good one. This one still works. And then I had one that was bad, and so I took the lathe and carefully parted it off so I could take the ends off and we can see what's inside of it. All right, so what's inside of this little fella? So here's the one that I cut apart. And so you can see on this end, this is the working end of it. So inside of here, you have the little cap that was friction welded or glued to it, so it was sealed up. And then there's a little spring backer, the spring. And then what's in here is actually a little plunger. And so it's got its own little spring on the inside. So this little guy goes down in that hole right in the middle, and it pushes on the other side to open up and let air in or out. And what went wrong with this one is that this guy is corroded. You can see that the spring has got corrosion on it. So when it went to plunge in, what happened is it plunged in and it got stuck. And when it got stuck, it opened up this side, and then air's flowing all the time. Well, it's too much air into the carburetor coming into the cylinder, and so it killed my front cylinder. So I took him off, blocked off the ports, and away we went. So this guy went bad because he got stuck. This little shaft right in here got stuck and left it open. So all we basically have is a little diaphragm on this side, and that runs a little plunger on that side, goes over to here. So what's inside of this side? So it's just got a cover. And then inside of there, it's got a screen. I can get it out of there. And some filter material. Let's see if I can get it out of there. There's filter material. And then on the back side is another little screen. So it goes together like that. So there's really nothing over there other than there's a valve inside of here. So that's basically the heart of this whole thing. A lot of complication for something that I don't really think it does much at all, other than when it goes bad, it aggravates you because your front cylinder will drop out on you. So let's have a look here over at this one and kind of see what the thing's supposed to do. And we'll check out a couple of these theories. All right, so the first theory is that this little guy, when you go up in high RPMs and then when you drop off real fast, your butterfly closes. And what that does is create a big vacuum. And with that big vacuum, there's an opportunity that you're gonna mess up your air-fuel mixture, and then it's gonna either backfire or it's gonna deaden the cylinder, it's gonna do something. So what this guy, the first theory is that he controls the vacuum and lets that vacuum off in order to stabilize the air-fuel mix so you don't get backfire. So let's just check that out and see if that's what this little guy does. So what I'm going to do is hook up a vacuum gauge and pretend that I am a vacuum puller. So what I'll do is squeeze this down, and you'll actually hear it burp or gulp, because they call it kind of a gulp valve. But when I pull up on the vacuum, it'll reach a point that it'll blow the vacuum off. So we go up and you heard it go pop. I'm going to do it again. There you go. That was a good loud one. And what it's doing is, right at the point that the vacuum comes up, that little diaphragm slides in, pushes this, opens the valve, and lets air in. And you can see that the vacuum gauge blops for a second. But then it'll continue going up. So what it does is just lets a little bit of air in there. But once it does it one time, it closes back off, and so you don't get much more. So it's a pretty neat little valve in that it'll only let it burp one time and then it closes back off. So what it's doing is just taking that one gulp of air, stripping out the fuel out of the carburetor, getting that cleaned out, and then it'll go ahead and decel. So looks like the theory is correct just based on how it works. You can hit it real hard and it'll open up. After that, doesn't do anything. So there we go. So it looks like that's the theory. And that's also what it actually does. But we'll talk about a few more things that this thing might do and a few more theories. All right, so for the second theory of what this thing does is, I've heard that some folks think that it is a valve kind of like on a car that when you have a rapid decel and your butterflies close, what it does is it opens up and it adds extra air into it to avoid the backfire on the cylinder until you regain the throttle pedal. But we can see that that's not the case, because just like we saw a minute ago, when I pump it up, it burps one time and then it just continues to climb. So it's only going to do it one time. It's just enough to clean out the carburetor, and then it'll continue on up its vacuum. It looks like the design was the way Yamaha has said what it was supposed to do is be a little gulp valve. But I can tell you from experience that there's one thing that this little guy does that I've never seen anybody talk about, but I know for a fact that it does it, and we can kind of show it with the little valve. Okay, so on to something that this little valve actually does that's a benefit to us is that you'll notice that it's only on the front cylinder. So you wonder, why did they just put it on the front cylinder? If it's so important to take that little gulp to clean the fuel out of the carburetor, why wouldn't it be important to do it on the back cylinder? Well, that's not all that this little guy is doing. And Yamaha, I think they knew it, and that's why they put it just on the front cylinder. Maybe it's to kind of EPA their way through something, but I can tell you right now, the guy's important for the front cylinder if you run the front cylinder to the specified fuel ratio. Because when these bikes were built, the front cylinder is a little bit leaner than the rear cylinder. And they do that because the rear cylinder gets hotter because there's not enough airflow. And the front cylinder has all the air pushing on it, so you can lean it out a little bit and it'll stay cooler. But the rear cylinder, they keep it cooler by keeping it richer. But having a leaner mix on that front cylinder causes a couple of things that probably everybody knows. It'll make them backfire because it's running a little bit lean. So when they do this, they're able to clean that front cylinder out so it won't backfire. The other thing that front cylinder likes to do is, because it's running lean, it'll pop back into the carburetor. And so this little guy, although he's a vacuum mixture control valve, he does a vital little function about keeping the air from popping back in the carburetor. Because not only does he do a vacuum, you can see the burp, and then it goes on up. So he's doing his job real well. The other thing he does is, if something happens that the carburetor blows back, like the cylinder fires and it blows back up into the carburetor, a lot of times you'll find fuel. Sometimes you'll pop a carburetor off. I've done that a time or two because I take these off. You got to make sure your carburetors are tight. And where these little guys were connected to the boot on the carburetor, you put a plug on top of them, but then you got to put a little clamp on, like one of these little guys right here. It's got to be strong enough to hold it, because when it does it without this valve, it'll pop the carburetor off, or it'll pop one of those little guys off. So let me get an airline and I'll actually show you that not only does it do vacuum, but it also does this very fine feature that is actually handy on this valve. All right, so let's say instead of a vacuum when we close the throttle down, let's say we're running along, we're not quite warm yet, our mix is a little bit off, and it builds up enough and it pops back in the carburetor like it gets a hiccup. I don't know if yours does that, mine will do it every once in a while, just, you know, the stars are in the right alignment or whatever, and it'll make this hiccup back through the carburetor. Well, when it does that hiccup, what it's doing is building pressure inside the carburetor, and so it'll act a lot like if you put pressure in it. So watch this. When I put pressure in it, it also blows that pressure out. So you think, maybe that's why that's on that front cylinder, because the front cylinder is the one that's tuned a little bit lean, and so it's going to be the one that pops back. The rear cylinder hardly ever does it because it's tuned a little richer. Now, one of the reasons why I can take them off my bikes and not have any worries is that I tune the carburetors to sound. I tune them to running. I don't tune them to their specifications on rich and lean. And so I can get away with it because my front carb is typically richer than what the factory setting would be. If somebody still has one that's stock set up, whole nine yards, made up just like Yamaha, and somebody actually went to the trouble to tune the thing, then tuned to factory settings, you might want to consider keeping this guy on there, because if that front cylinder is running at its spec, which is a little bit lean, every once in a while you'll get that pop back and it'll go, and what it does is releases that air so it won't try to pop your carburetors off or pop the little caps off where you took this thing loose. So really, that's the only thing that I can see this does as a big benefit. But one of the things that for sure I know, that when the carburetor pops and it'll pop off, I can tell you exactly that it does it, because you can't really see anything on it other than on this side of it. You can see, if the camera can get the angle right, it is just nasty with carbon. And what is happening, if we look at the little covers, you see the outside one is pretty clean. It doesn't have too much going on. The little filter is in the middle. On the inside one, you can see all of the soot that has built up where this guy is popping back when that carburetor pops, or the cylinder pops and it blows back in the carburetor. All of that is burnt fuel that is building up on this little guy, and he's been popping open over the past 40 years and keeping those carburetors from popping off of the boots. And that's most likely why they kept it on the front cylinder, because that one has a tendency to pop. So there we go. We figured out why it's just on the front cylinder, and we also figured out what it does for a living on the bike. But we're going to go a little bit further, and we're going to look at what all the little parts do, because I made up a little clear cap, and we can pull vacuum on it, and we can kind of see what everything does. Then you can see exactly what this little guy is doing, and you can make a decision on whether or not you want to keep it. All right, so we got the one I took apart, set up in the vise, and got it pinched together because it doesn't have glue on it anymore, but it still seals up. And so what I did is replace the black cap with a clear one so we can see what's going on in there. So this is the diaphragm side that's gonna push a little plunger that goes over to this side. This is the side that had all the carbon on that little filter from where it had been popping back over the years, because the front cylinder is set leaner. And so this one naturally has a tendency to pop back. It's also the side that when you hit a high vacuum draw and the throttle closes, this guy pulls in, that opens up and allows the air to come in and do the one-time burp to clean out the throat of the carburetor so you don't have backfire through the exhaust system. So all I'm gonna do is pump him up, just like I did with the other one. We'll use the little pumper. And what you'll see is, as I pump it up, this is gonna move. So I'll pump it up slow and you can see it move. So there it moved in. But I didn't make it burp, because that was just slow. But if I pump it up fast, it's gonna burp just like the other one. And you can hear it burp. Now this one is a little bit messed up because I took it apart. And so even if I glued it all back together, it's not gonna work anymore, because it no longer just gives one burp, it'll just continue to burp. And so that spring right there has gotten messed up when I took it apart, or I don't have that cap the right distance. So this one just continues to burp. But you get the idea, as you can see the little valve moving back and forth when I pump it up. And in the same respect, if I take the vacuum off and I put air into it, it's gonna blow off, which is what it's really been doing most of its life. So we'll put an air line on it, and then when I hit it, you can see that this one pushes backwards, but it doesn't need to push it. There's so much air coming in here that it just opens the valve for you. All right, so there you go. So since I don't run my front carburetor lean like the original factory settings, I don't have to worry about these guys, so I take them off. And they went up in the attic, and now they're just going to go in the trash. If you still wanted to run the front cylinder as lean as the original specifications, it might be an idea to consider keeping this guy. And then if you wanted to check it, in the book it says to rev it up to 5,000 RPMs or some crap like that, and I don't even understand why that tests this valve, because that has nothing to do with what this valve is doing. It must just be something that it does. It sucks a little bit of air in here once you hit that high RPM or that much pull on it. But if you really wanted to check it, all you got to do is just put the two lines together and then hook it up to a vacuum gauge, squeeze it, and if it burps one time, then you know the thing's working. And if you can hold a vacuum that's pretty steady, it'll drop back down on its own, then you know the thing's working. You can continue on. If your front cylinder falls out and you don't know why, disconnect that little guy and cap off the two little ports that are on the carb boot, and if it fires back up, then you know the little guy's bad. So there we go. case anybody was wondering what was going on with that little valve, now you know. And we can see that it does serve some purposes and it does do what Yamaha intended it to do. But more importantly, it'll keep you from blowing your carburetors off if you have a backfire up into the carburetor. Well, alrighty. Well, thanks for watching.